Good morning, students. Now the next topic which we will be covering is Bayesian belief networks. Okay. Now Bayesian belief networks is based on the property of conditional independence. When I talk about conditional independence, let's see what is conditional independence. Now I flip a coin. Okay. When I flip a coin, the probability of getting a hit is 1/2. Right? You have two possibilities. Two is nothing else but it can be a head or tail. But when I flip a coin, if it is a proper coin, I can get only one head. So probability of getting a head is 1/2. This is one probability of action. Now imagine if that particular day was a Tuesday and I flip a coin. Will that particular probability change? It will not change. So irrespective of another condition, the probability of these two random variables will not change. That is what we call as conditional independence. Conditional independence. So Bayesian belief networks is based on this concept of conditional independence. That means when I have say possibility of two random variables occurring is given, and then there is a third variable. Now this variable is completely independent of the other variable. Okay, so that is what we call as conditional independence. Now Bayesian belief network, it is a graphical representation of this conditional independence. So Bayesian belief network, it is nothing else but a graphical representation of conditional independence. Now here there are two things which occur whenever I'm representing a Bayesian belief network. First one is it contains two components. One is a qualitative component, and a quantitative component. Qualitative component is a directed acyclic graph. Okay, so whatever values I have, I am going to represent them using a DAG structure. That is a directed acyclic graph. That is your qualitative component. Your DAG. Quantitative component is the probabilities of each of those components occurring. That is your quantitative component. So your Bayesian is represented by these two components. Okay. Now supposing I have a network. Say, how you are going to represent this? I told you it is based on the concept of conditional independence. Okay. Now let's begin. We say that we are supposing we have three. Now mathematically I am going to represent. I told you what is conditional independence. Now we will represent them mathematically. I have three variables. Okay, now occurrence of Z, X is independent of the occurrence of Y given Z. Another example I will give. I have two people coming, going to their respective homes. Okay, so person A and person B. Now person A going home is completely independent of person B going home given the climatic conditions of the particular place. So X represents person A, Y represents person B, and the weather condition is Z. Okay. So if I say person A goes home at 9, person B goes home at 11, given it is a cold weather. Now thus here person A going home is completely independent of person B going home given the weather conditions. That is what we call as conditional independence. Now just because A is going at 9, B also will not go at 9. They are two independent factors given a third condition. That is what we call as conditional independence. So your Bayesian belief network is based on the concept of conditional independence. Okay, now mathematically representing, we have three variables over here, X, Y, and Z. So how are you going to represent? is independent of y is equal to yj given z equal to zk. Okay? X is independent of y given z. So, xi is the individual values in x. X is a set of values. Yi, yj is the individual values in y. Zk is individual values in z. So, this can also be represented as, since these two are independent parameters, I can also write this as probability of x is equal to xi, which is independent of z equal to z, or given the value of z is equal to z. Okay? So, how we can still further simplify this? If xi is nothing else but x1 to xn. So, this can further be written as probability of x1 to say xn is independent of y1 to yn given z1 to zn. Okay, this parameter is independent of this given this. So this can be in a way here we can write this as probability of, because they are independent, z1 to z. We are not considering this because these two are independent terms. Okay? So if I represent the same thing using a and b variables, now instead of x and y, supposing my variables are a and b, so I can write it as probability of a1, a2 given b. Okay? Now a1 and a2 are the independent variables. This is equal to, since they are independent, I can write it as probability of thunder is independent of the probability of forest fire. knowledge which we can get from your Bayesian belief network. I hope this is clear. We will do a problem, a similar problem on this. Okay.
Person E1, first person.
You can take P equal to P1 is equal to, sorry, P2 is equal to true, P2 equal to false. Okay, true and false. Here it is 0.80, 0.01. So this will be 0.20, 0.99. Now these many values are given to you along with your graph structure. Now what have they asked you to find? They have asked you to find the probability that, okay, P1 is true. So P1, P2 is true. P2, alarm has gone. A, when there is no burglar. So not B and no fire. Not F. This probability you are supposed to find. Okay? Now first we take P1. Probability of P1. P1 spelled is what? It is alarm. So probability of P1 given A. Okay? Into only one parent. Next P2. P2 is true. Probability of P2 given A. Probability of P2 given A. Okay? Now alarm. Next one is A. Alarm. Alarm has two parents, earlier given fire. Both have not occurred. So what you write here? Into probability of alarm given no burglary and no fire. Okay? Next parameter, probability of no burglary. That has no parent. So this is probability of no burglary. Into fire has no parent. Into probability of no fire. This much we have to find. Okay? Okay. The first one, probability of P1 equal to 2 when alarm is 2. So alarm is over here. P1 is 2 when alarm is 2 is 0.95. So the first value is 0.95 into P2 2 when alarm is 2. P2 is how much here? P2 is 2. Alarm is 2. 0.80 into 0.80. Okay, now see here. Probability of alarm when there is no burglary and no fire. No burglary and no fire. This is the probability of alarm. No burglary, no fire is both are false. False, false condition and alarm is false is 0.999. So into 0.999 into probability of no burglary is how much? Where is it? Burglary, false. Yeah, this is, yeah, into 0.998. Yeah, here it is. Burglary is equal to false is 0.5. No fire. The last one is probability of no fire and probability of no burglary. No burglary is 0.999. No fire is 0.999.